Hi, I'm Keith Willey with Hubbell Power Systems. And today, we're going to talk about how to install the 1,000-pound Chance Capstan hoist and accessories to the back of a truck. So today, we have a fixture that's representing a 2-inch hitch mount for the back of a pickup truck. So the first step in assembling this is to put the plate inside your 2-inch mount. It slides in. Now, we have a pin and a key here. It does not come with the plate. Every truck has different hole sizes, but you have to have a pin and a key, and you need to assemble to make sure that's locked in place. Now that we have the truck mount in, the next step is to put the swivel bracket onto the truck mount. The swivel bracket comes with grade 5 bolts. Use grade 5 bolts when you assemble this. If you ever happen to lose or have to replace a bolt, make sure you use a grade 5 bolt. That gives it the strength it needs to make sure you have protection. So very simply, assemble. There are 4 holes. Assemble it right on top. Bolt facing down, and then the washer and nut facing up. Make sure you have these all tightened down, not just hand tightened, but tightened securely with the tool. Okay, now that we have the swivel mount securely fashioned, the next step is to install the C bracket. The C bracket, you'll notice, has a pin on one side, and we also have a pin on the swivel mount bracket. I'll talk about this pin later, but the pin on the swivel mount is designed to force us to put the C mount in the correct configuration. Then very quickly, we have 4 bolts. These bolts are secured with a 1/2-inch Allen wrench. And like before, we'll make sure that we secure these very tightly with the Allen wrench. All right, we have the C mount bracket tightly secured. The next item is to put the capstan hoist through the C bracket. Now earlier, I spoke about this pin here in the C bracket. It's going to come into play now. The newer C brackets from Chance come with this pin, and that pin forces you to install the capstan hoist correctly onto the mount. If you have an older C bracket, just recognize if there's no pin on it, that when you install the capstan hoist, the drum of the capstan hoist has to be over the center, this large center bolt in the setup here. So let's go ahead and show you. So the hoist motor body goes through the capstan, the C bracket here, and the drum of the capstan should be over this bolt. This is the correct configuration. The safety bar here, we'll talk about that later, should be on the back side of the load. So in this case, the load would be in front of me, and this is the back side. There are 6 bolts that come with the C bracket, and those 6 bolts are used to install the capstan hoist. When installed correctly, you'll notice that there's one more hole here, a threaded hole. That threaded hole is used for other accessories, not necessarily for bolting this down. So let's go ahead and install these and tighten them down securely. Now we have the capstan hoist mounted properly and we're ready to start work. Obviously on a real work site, you'd be wearing all your safety equipment, your gloves, glasses, hard hat, anything in appliance with OSHA or your work site instructions. I have hooked up the hoist to the power. What we're using here is a foot power cord. The foot power should be behind the load, behind the hoist. So as you're working the hoist, you can see your work site. This rope is very important. You really want to stay away from ropes that are made of plastic that have low melt temperatures, because the friction this may cause may melt that rope and give you issues. Also, ropes like hemp don't work, because hemp, while strong normally, when it gets frozen, it can actually break. The best ropes to stick with are double braided synthetic ropes for products like this. So make sure you're using a good rope for a product. So you'll see on this hoist that we have this item here. This is a rope hook. This rope hook is a safety measure and is on all the Chance hoists. If you have hoists that don't have these, make sure you contact your distributor. This item is designed to make sure that that rope does not slip off of the drum and have loads fall on you. So what we want to do now is take that rope and wrap it 3 to 4 times. If I'm facing the end of the drum turns counterclockwise, and that's exactly how I'm going to wrap the rope. And I just go to the underside of the rope hook, and we're ready to go. Now that we're finished with the assembly of the capstan hoist, I put the rope in, and I want to point out one alignment issue here. You'll see the rope is not aligned with the project. It's very important that the rope be aligned with the project. In this case, if we started the hoist, that rope would start bunching here, and that can give you problems. You don't want the bunching rope. Thankfully, that's an easy thing to fix with a swivel mount capstan hoist. because by simply removing the pin in the back here, you're allowed to swivel the bracket to another position until it locks in to give you more alignment that you need with the rope. So if your truck is not aligned exactly, you can align the pin. One more thing about the pin, if you notice over time that that pin is starting to bend, it means that you really don't have a correct alignment overall, and you need to make sure that you stay more aligned with the project. So keep that in mind when you do this. In this particular configuration, we have a rope that's set up to go to a heel block. A heel block is a structure on the bottom of a vertical tower. It allows the rope to go to the block and then go straight up. Just one note about blocks. Make sure that when you're using a block that you have to recognize that you double the load that you're carrying when you're using a block. All right, another popular configuration is obviously to have the block on the tower, and this simulation shows that block is on the tower. Again, recognize that the block is seeing twice the load when you have a block up there. And just like before, get ready to use it. Make sure that you're looking at the tower, the load, and all the folks on the job site. If things are a go, we're ready to go. All right, so now I'd like to show a secondary safety device that we offer. This is an optional device. It's called a rope lock device. This device allows the rope to come through here one way and not to be able to slip back. So if you fall or trip, the rope won't go back through. If you're using this, it gets mounted to the C bracket with these two bolts. So the rope lock is installed and we're gonna install the rope. We basically pull down at the top here and that'll push that up to give us leeway to put that rope in there, and it locks down and we're ready to go. This comes with an additional rope. So if you ever have to back off of your load, because this stops it from backing off, if you lift that up, then it will allow the rope to back off in case you need to back it off somewhat. All right, now that we have this assembled, just want to cover four critical points to review before we get started. First of all, make sure that you have the rope hook on here for safety. Number two, make sure the drum is over the center of the swivel bracket. Number three, make sure you have between 3 and 4 wraps on the drum. And number four, make sure that you have it situated where you're on the back side of the hoist, facing the structure, and then you're ready to go. If you'd like more information on Capstan Hoist and Accessories, please contact GME Supply.